so good. Apple cider vinegar.
Yeah, with lemon.
With lemon. It's like
water.
It's like a fruity drink.
Yeah, and it's blood cleanser. It allows the pH of your body, which is meant to be alkalinized, to be alkalinized.
I admit I don't drink enough water.
Yeah, I've got to push her to drink it. But I try to do at least a whole, and I used to drink a gallon a day, but you know, right now I'm pushing the 32 ounces, which is not enough, but we eat a lot of fruits, and we eat a lot of, food that has a lot of water content, and we try to stay away from dehydrating foods because, you know, people think, well, I drink fruit juices and coffee. Well, coffee is caffeinated, and caffeine dehydrates you, as do sugary drinks.
And then your skin, all of a sudden you see it, like, it becomes leathery.
Leathery, and when you do this, if it's, you know, not bad. If this stays, when you go like that, and it doesn't bounce back, you're super dehydrated. So that's the number one tell sign right there.
I'm hydrated. Check it out. Yeah. This is gonna go in.
The car tomorrow.
The car tomorrow. With us. We're gonna be sleeping around it, or on it?
We'll have to figure it out.
I don't know. We've got certain things that we gotta... Because we haven't really seen what is going to happen.
No.
It's all a theory right now.
But. Yeah. And right now we're taking in our Xfinity box.
Yay! The last time we probably would ever pay for Comcast.
Yeah, overpriced, and they want to get you by the cojones, but...
You need help?
There's other stuff there that needs to be carried, so I gotta figure this out.
You do. We got bags of clothes
that we're taking, and
we got a weight, a scale. Anybody want a scale? We can't really take the scale with us.
Let me see if I can do this. And that should work. Okay, so I'm gonna do this on the
door. Can you move
door.
My little Osmo device thing onto the couch?
Okay.
Thank you.
There we go.
All right.
We're heading out.
More errands. More things to run to people that need it. Because we're not those people.
Yeah, we gotta wash the car.
Oh yeah, we gotta wash the car, so we'll take you to our car wash as well. Beautiful, sunny Florida day. I can feel the humidity. It's already creeping up on us, is it not?
Yes.
So... got to get away from, well, you like humidity though, don't you?
I don't mind.
Yeah. It's a good thing to sweat. Yeah. Some people are afraid to sweat. It's really not that big a deal. Yep. So we got, it's going to be interesting because this is our living quarters here. It doesn't open up anymore. It doesn't really change a whole lot. This comes off, the seats flip down, and you got like about six and a half feet of space to, you know, stretch your legs out and stuff. So we'll
make it happen.
We're gonna make it happen. We've got this little area underneath that's like a little storage area. There's a little window, so I'm gonna turn off. It is toasty.
Very hot.
Toasty warm in here.
Why isn't that?
It's not turning on. Oh wait, it's a hybrid. It doesn't need all that.
And it's turning on because of the AC. I always try to turn the AC off. I forgot yesterday.
And we forgot to put our thing on.
Our buttons are trying to start doing.
Whoa, what is that?
I don't know, the brakes feel funny. Hmm.
So yeah, this is one of the last times we're going to pull out here before we leave for good.
Well, that's a real nice place to go, mister.
Yeah, I mean, the guy is riding a bicycle and he's riding it
on the wrong side of the road. And I'm like getting ready to make a turn.
And it's like he's in the middle of the road. not on the side.
That was weird. I went to brake going backwards, and sometimes I see the brake
catches
and disengage.
Yeah, but Prius uses a different kind of braking system. It's like there are some people that have, you know, not once changed out their brake pads because the car is just, it's crazy. It just, they built it different than other cars. So
it's like learning to drive all over again, a different way of driving.
But you're figuring it out. Of course, we're down to 48 miles per gallon now. She really does not like the back and forth.
Stop and go, stop and go. She likes to go.
Why don't we tell people a little bit about that?
What, the globe?
Yeah.
La paz sea con ustedes. May peace be with you. And, you know, one of the things, I was having a discussion on Facebook with someone who's like, always talking about how bad things are. And I said, things are as they should be. And somebody comes and says, what do you mean things are as they should be? No, they're not. Things aren't as they should be. And I said, there's a shift that's taking place. And in order for the shift to take place, all the commotion that appears to be happening needs to happen. Because until people find peace within, which is, you know, that what that is saying, then you're not going to have peace outside of you. So it's a major exciting time to be.
We got this as a gift from your sister recently, and it just fits perfectly.
We forgot to bring the other feathers. Oh, I didn't have any
hands. Yeah, we found some cool feathers. If you saw our...
It's going to be our feather collector.
Yeah.
Just like fill it all up.
If you saw our video yesterday or this morning or whatever, found a bunch of feathers down on over by the riverfront. Gosh, this traffic.
I can't stand it. So glad.
It's like it doesn't just go away.
No.
See, look. Oh, it stopped. It stopped. There was so much traffic. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go into Xfinity and bring back overpriced equipment that we never, well, you pay a rental fee for it.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't get that. Before, people had the option of buying their own modem and stuff like that or whatever, and now, you know, they charge like $10 a month for equipment, you know, or more. And the box that we're returning,
we never even opened or used.
It's still in the cellophane that
we don't have a TV
in.
We had a projector, so but that was the way that would give me the deal of $15 if it was some sort of something or another. They're always trying to con you and telling you, well, we're gonna give you this and that and the other, and then, you know, they stick it to you at another.
It's like you see a fee. Like just the other day we were looking at our T-Mobile bill and it was like, where did this $18
come from?
Dollars show up on our bill. It's just, I mean, we got a really good plan. It's like $100, right?
Yeah.
So it's $100.
Unlimited and then 10 gigabytes of hotspot for each one of our phones.
Right. So if you're looking for a plan, guys, check out T-Mobile. They have something really good going on right now.
Except when they try to, like, throw
Except
it in.
Except when they nickel and dime you behind your back. It's like, and I asked... You know, or you asked.
Yeah. And they can tell us, well, we're sorry, we'll take those charges out, but they never really explain to us why they appeared there in the first place.
Yeah.
I guess they're hoping people don't, like, pay attention.
They're hoping people just let automatic payment take care of it, and they don't even look at their bill.
Yeah.
And it doesn't work like that for us.
I check every
day.
I'm like,
I mean, yeah. It would never have gone past.
And they created the word frugal. It had me in mind. But you
frugal,
have to be.
The frugal minimalist.
Yep. You have to be, because if not, that eats you up alive. Better in my pocket than in their pocket.
It's true.
You know? So.
But it's one of those things where if you're not aware of what's going on, they take advantage of you. And that goes for anything. I mean, out. It's like, all of a sudden, your mortgage payment, you look at it, it went up, and they're like, oh, didn't we tell you we were going to raise the interest rate after a certain month?
Yeah.
You know, it's like, wait a minute, I thought I had a fixed rate, you know. Oh, no, due to inflation, it's like,
Totally rip you off.
At any, you know, opportunity they may have. So anyway, we're going to pop into this
Xfinity roadkill. People don't pay attention to kill things. Because they're on their phone or they're texting or doing something.
Yeah, we were walking down to the Riverwalk and it was like two ladies. One was walking by and she had her eyes down looking at her phone. And another lady, younger, walking by looking at her phone. It's like people spend all their time looking at phone screens.
Yeah. That's what they do. No eye contact, no connection. I think we're connected. We're connected to the wrong things. Okay, so Xfinity is
right over here. Oh, right there.
Right?
Left.
No, I said right. It's over there. I saw the sign there. Yeah. So I'm like thinking, okay, well,
there it is.
Xfinity.
Show me Netflix. People, life is more than Netflix.
And more than computers. And to tell you the truth, the only reason we're on this is because we want to bring you guys, you know, information.
So, we returned that stuff to Xfinity, not without hassles with billing again, because that's what they do, but we're not going to fret the small stuff anymore. They can rip us off one last time, I guess.
Yeah.
But we're here at donation drop-off for a place here in Fort Lauderdale that helps the LGBT community a lot, and it's called Out of the Closet.
We've been giving these people tons of stuff. Been coming here for the longest.
Founded in 1987, AIDS Healthcare Foundation is the U.S.'s largest HIV AIDS healthcare prevention and education provider.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Appreciate
it. Because we're moving, so we've been bringing stuff to you guys.
Thank you. Right. You have a wonderful day.
You too.
So yeah, it's a good organization, and I'm glad that we could help them. And they're also really close to our apartment. You know why I'm feeling really warm? It's 88 degrees outside. There is a reason right there. It's really warm and humid.
Yes.
And I don't really do well with humidity.
Nope, that's why.
But I've gotten used to it. I deal with it, but it's not really my favorite thing. Unless, you know, I'm at a beach somewhere, palm trees. We got the palm trees.
Yeah.
The beach is back that way.
Yep.
So, we are off to wash the car. Are we gonna like wash it, or are we gonna just wash it? What kind of wash are we going to do on the car? Because usually we just wet it and let it air dry. And, you know, we just kind of clean it off. Or are we going to do some kind of a detailed job?
Well, I don't think I'm going to do detail because we're going to still be parking on the same place that does this.
So we're just going to wash it off like we do?
Kind of. I mean, I want to like get really good in here and
Get
rid of all these thingies.
You should have brought some newspaper or something for the windows. Windex. Because we're not. Do we have drying towels?
No.
So we're just going to wash the car off. And vacuum it in a little bit more and get rid of some of those pesky dog hairs that show up every time we do something in the car. It seems like they show up. But on tonight. Tonight's our last night in the apartment. Because tomorrow night, we will be demoing our new home.
We'll be sleeping.
We'll be sleeping in the parking lot of our apartment. Just to, you know, get baptized by fire here. Figure out how exactly everything's gonna fit. I'm not really that worried.
Nope.
I mean, I'm a little worried, but you know, if things don't fit, we'll just have to, you know, leave more things behind.
That's why we're doing what we're doing.
And we're not gonna take out the spare tire to do it. So. It's gonna be interesting. I'm sure you guys are gonna be like, there's no way they're going to do it. It's like, yeah, well, where there's a will,
there is a way.
There is a way. And we will find it. That is for sure. So she gets pretty dirty where we live because we have a big coconut tree that makes its home, right? Well, the coconut tree actually has every right to be there. We're probably the one that's been the invader, but you know, we have it dropping junk on our roof and all on the paint. It looks all like, you know, like it gets all speckled and bumpy and stuff. So that's why we're here, to clean it off.
So this is by the minute. The Amazon will be offering a complete line of vacuum and car care.
So you're gonna what? Start off with?
We still have to do the vacuum. God, that smell.
Whew. I don't know. It smells like mothballs. So we're gonna start off with what? High pressure.
Yeah.
So we're gonna. Where's that? That's where you're at.
Oh, high pressure.
High pressure. You wanna start off with high pressure soap or high pressure rinse? Pressure soap and then no, that'll take too much time.
So what do I and then keep going?
Yep, there you go, you got 5 minutes. 5 minutes. He starts without a question. Put that trigger down. There you go. Now you're cooking. Wasn't bad.
Nope.
You can't really do a fine detailed job because where we live is again,
yeah, it's like
dust
waste,
prone. They're
like,
they're constructing stuff too. They're building things, so probably get cement dust and other things.
Other crap.
And now we're gonna vacuum.